long in 10 years time. Let's say 30 kilometers out of Nairobi in the coffee growing zones, which means from Nairobi going out this way, most of the land will most likely be having
houses
in 10 years.
Yeah.
I don't want to say there will be no coffee. Yes, there will be some coffee, but one thing I can say, what I'm finding is that the market signals have been very good. Farmers have applied lots of fertilizers, all the necessary agro inputs, and productivity per tree has gone up. In some of the cases, and Doug, maybe I'll talk more about our old relationship before he divorced me. They divorced me. We have been working with farmers for quite some time, from 2006, and doing lots of quality improvement projects. There was even a proposal which we had written to you in Ikafe when Alessio Colucci, was that his name?
Yeah.
Colucci, when he was around, we had written a proposal, we worked together. And what we saw, what we have seen is that the productivity per tree has gone up. I'll give an example, and you know Gekanda Duck. Last year, they produced only 800,000. This year, they are on 2.7
kilos
of cherry.
Cherry, yes.
Which means from only about 120 tons, this year they are talking about 400 odd
tons of clean coffee.
Clean coffee.
Yes.
I've got another one called Muyengwe in Kirinyaga.
Yes.
Their average has always been around 1.1 million. This year they are on 3.9 million kilos of cherry.
So four times.
So there is few. Kenya coffee production does not mean because we are going to lose some land around Nairobi that our production will go down. Provided the market signals are what we are seeing, the farmers will continue improving the yield per tree, because if he's producing 1 kilo of cherry per tree, yet a coffee tree can produce even up to 30 kilos of cherry. That's where I think we should put more effort.
Yeah.
And that's where, sorry to say this, Doug, it is nice when I have a roaster, because it would be nice if you work in quality improvement or training the farmers on good agricultural practices.
Yes.
Because if they get to know what they need to do to improve the production from 1 kilo per tree to 10, we are not going to argue about production going down.
Yes.
So yeah. I'm happy. Kenya's production is estimated at 400 kilos green coffee per hectare. On the farms which has implemented good agricultural practices, which has got good management in place, we are seeing, like now, Mr. Kirene's farm, Makiu Estate, we are doing 2.25 tons per hectare. So, smallholder sector is the one which is pulling Kenya production down, because it's the one at around 400. But these farms, like where we are right now, the yields are 5 times what the smallholder person is doing. So if we work with
more intense, the plantation.
Yes, the plantation.
Well, good management. Practice.
Good management.
Just the same plants. The plants are always 1,000.
The same plants per hectare are the same.
Yes.
So if we just train the farmers, and that's what I was telling Francesco, a roaster-driven initiative to try and work with the farmers who supply you with the coffee to improve production will lead to
multiples.
Yeah. And farmers nowadays love to do things when it is initiated more by the final buyer of their coffee. If you try to, let's say I go to the various donor organizations and I start working with farmers and tell them it's a donor-driven project, somehow it doesn't work, Doug.
Yes.
I've seen that.
Yes.
Even if I'm trying to do certification, or even in case I'm trying to do whatever, people will say, oh, these are people who feel guilty, they want to tell us we do certain projects. But when they hear it's coming from the roaster who buys the coffee, they are very committed. The flower tubes are growing very well and all that. So right now we are applying color. We also apply zinc. if let's say it's about, we are about to harvest the coffee in the month of, let's say, September, October, I will do foliar feeds very high in potassium because you need more potassium to ripe, to have uniform ripening.
NPK.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And for fertilizers, they're also specific. Right now, the rains what we had last 2 months, we apply an NPK. But later on, in the month of April, May, we apply a calcium ammonium nitrate. High nitrogen levels. We don't use urea.
Urea
we can only apply foliar feed because urea is very acidic,
yeah.
And the correct soil pH for coffee should be around 5.4 if you are using the method of analysis called the calcium chloride. So you need something.
And we've put some lime.
Right now, the lime which you saw when you're coming in is we did the soil analysis. And maybe the soil pH was about 4.5, 4.7.
Yeah.
And we had to do 2.5 tons per hectare just to push the soil pH by just 0.2.
Okay.
Just you need 1 ton per hectare to move your soil pH from, let's say, 4.5 to 4.6. So to do 2.5, I've just tried to increase it by 0.25.
And this is just lime?
This is just lime, 50% calcium. If I want to use Magmax, which is magnesium and calcium, that would be on the basis of the soil analysis reports. If the feedback comes that I need to apply Magmax, then I would apply that. We work with the smallholder farmers. We also work with plantations. Coffee Management Services, number one, manages large plantations on behalf of the owners. We are currently managing 1,300 hectares of coffee land belonging to the big plantations like this one. Currently managing about 16 different units to make the 1,300 hectares. And we are also working with the smallholder farmers. Within 6 years' time, CMS now is the number one. Is a leading coffee marketing company.
Coffee?
We are handling 18% of Kenyan coffee production right now. And that, for your information, this year there is no way I will not be 20% in handling the volumes. No. We have got two dry mills. One is in a place called Karatina, about 130 kilometers away. That is at the home of the best coffee growing zones. I'll just show you from this side. This is a map of Kenya Coffee Map. We are here. Ruiru is between Nairobi and Thika. This is where we are. And this is the area which I was saying, maybe around here, drawing it like that, 30 kilometer radius from here. I expect 10 years going down the road, there will be less coffee. More of the coffee will be here. So the home of the top quality coffees in Kenya is around here. And that is where our dry mill is.
Mm-hmm.
And with the assistance of Dark, when we used to work together, we put up a new dry mill in a place here called Eldoret to tap into the new coffee growing zone of this area. This normally was for growing maize, corn, mm-hmm. for Kenya, for the people, but people are now planting more and more coffee. So we have put up another dry mill. And like I indicated, even though this area around here might be out of coffee, we have got new areas, people are planting more coffee. So we will continue seeing 50, 60,000 production, provided the market signals continue being good. Farmers will continue planting more coffee.
Okay.
So you got this legend giving you all the information about where the coffees are, what you can get.
I didn't mean that.
That's the best.